Good morning. I'm Cody Wintersheet with Paragon Ag Advisors. We are now past the highly touted January 12th crop report. The markets received a lot of various numbers to digest, and none of which were overly surprising except for the wheat acreage numbers. With trade expectations coming in around 1.6 million less acres than a year ago, the USDA actually only lowered the acres by around 88,000 versus a year ago. So granted, the acres are less technically speaking, however, it's a far cry from what the market and trade was anticipating. And even though it's a decent time of year to have dry conditions in regards to the wheat, it does certainly put more emphasis on the spring rains once the crop breaks dormancy. As such, the latest monthly crop condition ratings also depicted a decent decline in some of the major wheat areas. Furthermore, corn, soybeans, and wheat all look to have plentiful ending stocks, which certainly is not new news. Our lagging exports are a big reason as to why the ending stocks remain steady to higher lately. Big picture, global demand does continue to grow year over year, however, the recent year's supplies have outpaced. The U.S. has also been losing market share to our competitors as well. There doesn't appear to be a new demand source on the horizon either, unlike the ethanol boom of roughly a decade ago. So it appears we're now hoping yet again for another significant weather event to help wake the markets up this year. That being said, if we can get that or some other spark for the market, keep in mind the outside markets are currently set up to be supportive with a weaker tone to the US dollar and what appears to be a much improved crude oil market. Thank you and have a great day.